chauvinistic, pacifistic son of a bitch.
Good morning, sunshine. What a glorious morning it is. Look at it. Sun is coming up there. I find myself an extra battery. The old one that I used to have on this phone, it was with me, and I thought I'll check it out if there's any electricity left in its cells yet. And you know, there was. So I am able to film you this last leg of the journey. It's something o'clock again. Morning time. I'm heading towards the car. There's 3.5 kilometers or so to go. I don't think there will be that much to see from yesterday, because I'm gonna head that sort of woods in there. It's a sort of like industrially used forestry bits. But anyway, I shall film you the best bits once again. Let's enjoy the rest of the day. Take it very slowly. My ankles are hurting quite a bit. Was expected. No. Tire tracks here. What the hell are there tire tracks here? Small wonder the night was a bit chilly. There has been freezing temperatures, it seems. Look at how beautiful those are. So about last night, really, just when I got myself squeezed into the sleeping bag, three young, well, I don't know if they were youngsters, but dudes anyway. Three dudes came there, sit by the fire and drink some beer, but they did behave like a gentleman. They kept their voices down to make sure that I got some sleep, but I didn't. I can sleep at home. It was a glorious starlit night. Bit chilly, but other than that, very beautiful fire. I kept small fire going all through the night. So now in the morning, I just rolled a big log over there and put some smaller wood in on top of that, and off it went. I get my morning coffee nice and warm. So now that it's done, like I said, this is a bit crowded. Crowded National Park due to its location. When you act like a gentleman, and I wanted to point out that those benches by the fireplaces are not for sleeping. So I who was rude this time. But I just didn't have the strength to get off the sleeping bag and start building a tent. So sorry fellows if you are watching. My bad. Hope I didn't ruin your night. There's the national park border. Can't you spot the difference? That side as well. And the spruces are just tremendous. So I don't think today there's gonna be that much to show, really, but let's just enjoy it anyway. Gorgeous weather. And if I have to think of something positive about forest industry malarkey, it keeps the forest more open, so there's more sunshine for me right now. That's a shallow thing, really. But anyway, let's keep on a happy face as I re-enter the park soon enough. Found out this sort of place. And this, I've completely forgotten that there was a this sort of project going on here in all Finland to restore the Finnish forest reindeer. into the area, and that is the fence where they rehabilitate those gorgeous, gorgeous animals. I should have remembered I applied for a job there. I disqualified, obviously, but anyway, it's very nice if they do that sort of thing. Imagine you get here a huge herd of Finnish forest reindeers walk about, pretty much like reindeers in Lapland, but only natural. Oh, that would be lovely. Hope they succeed. All the best for them, even though it didn't take me as a worker there. Well, as it happens, pretty much as soon as I exit the park area, there has been some clear-cut areas. There's a vast one. And there are some saplings there in the distance. And there's a sort of field which is called pine. And I'm sorry. They just claim the forest industry that the Finnish forest feel well. This is not the forest that feels well. I saw you just yesterday, but the forest that feels well, looks and feels like. This is not it. Well, perhaps individual trees in this sort of growing method feel well. Perhaps even better than, well, I don't know, no, that's a long shot. But anyway, in the forest that I saw you yesterday, but anyway. Oh no, this rant, I forgot all about what I was saying to you. Anyway, but the individual, even if the individual trees would feel better here, which I doubt, really, but that is perhaps something I can give the forest industry. But anyway, the forest as a whole, as a breathing, living ecosystem, that just, it's just non-existent here. Because this is not a forest, it's a field with some trees growing out of it. So perhaps we should consider it as a field and put it on a tax. And the only way to avoid tax is turn the field into a real forest, which is that it has some trees that are old, some trees that are young, and all different kinds of trees, depending upon the environment otherwise and such. But anyway, my rant is brutally interrupted by this fence. I'm not sure if I was supposed to come down here. But there was no sign on there to the camping place that I should not take this route. So there was none on the maps. There's another sign to say that about the Finnish forest reindeer. Ah, they have 14 acres of space there to wander about. It's very, very wonderful. So let's keep on focusing on the bright sides and positive sides. Forget about this whole forest industry malarkey. I should turn pretty soon to my left and start heading back towards the national park area, which will then again be a marvelous. The car is there on the Soljainen, as you remember. A little bit more than about exactly a mile if you live in a third world country such as England or America. 1.6 kilometers. Somehow the this is a completely off topic here, but somehow the mile is actually fits into your tongue much better in English than in kilometers or sort of kilometer. Car, unfortunately. But anyway, the kilometer sounds much more German. Ah, kilometer. It doesn't roll on your tongue like a mile. Okay. There's a beautiful river here. I remember this path that I'm taking now follows closely the river on the downside there, and about 7 or something years ago I was in another school project in a berry farm very nearby there, and my tent there on the Soljainen beach camping area, and I walked this path every time, morning and evening, and there's a beaver living in the river, as you can see. And as I was walking towards my campsite one evening in the moonlight with my trusty storm lantern with me, the beaver kept on slapping its tail on the water there. It was gorgeous. It was pitch black, other than the radius of my storm lantern, and I couldn't see a thing. I just heard every once in a while the splashing sound of the beaver's tail. It was such a gorgeous, gorgeous thing to be witnessing. Hey, re-enter the park. Sunshine and those moist ground areas there create such a perfect colors. Oh my goodness. Perhaps I should fill these gaps which are only videos of this place with some music, but I actually believe that near silence this place has music enough. Obviously some car noises in the distance, but perhaps they won't catch on the microphone there, so you won't be able to get annoyed. And there you have it. There's the burnt down area, just showed you in a day one imitation forest fire, as it's called. Beautiful. And there you can see glimpses of my ruined teenage booze drinking Mercedes. I'm gonna head off from this magnificent park. I already wrapped up my feelings of this place, but I still maintain it's a very good place to come for a short trip. If you live in Tampere or are in vacation in Tampere, rent a bicycle and cycle here on this Soljainen camping place and build a tent and you're on your way. From the Soljainen place there's very easy hike to the Multiharju. It's a path. There she is. Isn't she lovely? I am here at the parking lot. There you can see the nature center. Now it's bored. That I take there's a nature path here that leaves from this point, but as you can see it's rather crowded. And I say that this was a crowded place. I do mean it's a crowded place, so perhaps I just leave. Probably good one. Next time that I come here I shall come in a week. Weekdays. some point, perhaps. Or I just... perhaps I just got to Lapland. Anyway, it's a very nice... today's very nice views of all that. And yes, it is good that people go to those sort of places to get money flowing to the right stuff, so to speak. It's just, I think it's not for me overall. Well, anyway, it's been a pleasure. See you soon. Bye-bye.